Playing an instrument is kind of like playing 4D chess. Musicians harness multiple forms of memory, including muscle or procedural memory, which enables impressive feats of memorization. But muscle memory does have one flaw, because it doesn't memorize the information itself, but simply the physical movements to type it out. This is why almost all other champion memorists, such as Akira Haraguchi, who memorized over 100,000 digits of pi, Dominic O'Brien, who memorized a random sequence of over 2,800 playing cards, and even London taxi drivers, use a combination of two different forms of powerful memory. To harness it, you can use an ancient technique with its origins found both in ancient Greece, hunter-gatherer societies, and even the Stonehenge. It's called the Method of Loci. We have extremely good visual and spatial memories, which was, in the past, crucial for our survival, as it allowed us to find our way home and to recognize our surroundings. In comparison, we aren't nearly as adapted to memorizing information like the circle of fifths, the hundreds of terminologies in composing, or a list of names or musical instruments. But using the method of Loci, we can turn this information into visual and spatial memory. By first imagining a familiar route and distinct location, like your house or way to work, we can use this as a memory palace to store mental images associated with information. Identifying locations in the memory palace that are distinct yet unique, such as the spot next to your piano or home studio, creates anchors for these mental images. By then associating the information, such as a list of musical instruments, with the mental images in these distinct locations, we can simply recall the information by walking through the memory palace. But here's the catch. It's not enough to just imagine any plain mental image, but one that is as ridiculous, colourful, and vivid as possible. Not only imagining visually, but also using other senses like touch and smell. Our brains are attracted to novelty and strong sensory experiences, so in this way, you can make the method of Loci even more effective. For example, when you're learning the circle of fifths, for the pitch C, you could imagine a giant cabbage in your living room, picking it up and savouring its freshness. Then, with the pitch G, you could imagine a new guitar at your doorway, picking it up and savouring that new guitar smell, and so on. But this is just one possible solution. Ancient Greek poets and orators using the method didn't memorise various speeches and texts word for word, but topic to topic. In this way, you could memorize music by, for example, associating mental images with the emotion you feel in each part of a song, like Schubert's Impromptu No. 2. If the first part is elegant and happy, think of a window placed in your corridor overlooking a vibrant garden. If the next section is more pensive and intense, think of a painting reflecting those qualities placed on your kitchen counter. This can also make it easier to learn the piece using other forms of memory, like muscle memory, as you're actively processing the song and its emotions and form. The method of Loci isn't without its problems though. In composing, many of the terminologies start with the same letters, meaning we can't really use the same technique that we used for the circle of fifths. However, we can use a method called grouping to denote the two first letters instead. To remember the term adagio, imagine a tasty apple placed at the front of your door, also on the top of a drum set. And for the term allegro, imagine an aristocrat also playing the lute in your hallway. Another effective way could be to vividly imagine something that simply has a name that starts with the same letters as the thing you're trying to memorize, as loose association with information can make mental recall easier. But one important thing to keep in mind though is that the method of Loci trades speed for accuracy. And because we need to mentally recall images in a specific sequence, the longer down the route that image is, the longer it will take to retrieve. For example, the third piano concerto by Sergei Rachmaninoff contains almost 30,000 notes, played within roughly 45 minutes, meaning the pianist needs to play 10 notes per second, which is just far too fast for the method of Loci to be useful. But memorizing notes aside, what's even more interesting is that the people with superior memories like Haraguchi and O'Brien don't really have superior memories. Their brains aren't notably different compared to their normal counterparts, and they aren't any more intelligent. The only real difference is that they harness visual and spatial memory more. So by using the method of Loci, you can easily remember the entire circle of fifths, the entire form of a song, the hundreds of terminologies in composing, and even daily things like studying and so on. Having a superior memory isn't about having a superior brain or even a good memory, but having a superior method. Thanks for watching and all your support in the last video.